Hi, I'm Matt from Utah Trikes, and today we're going to talk about doing alignment on your trike. The tools you'll need to do your alignment are, if you have one, a Calibro, very handy tool, or rather than that, you can use a tape measure, and then a set of metric box end wrenches.
The initial step you want to do before doing your alignment is not necessary, but very convenient, is put it on a stand or on a table or something like that to keep it from rolling away or moving or anything like that. Next, take your tools, and with one you'll hold the tie rod end. With the other, you will loosen the jam nut on the tie rod.
Some systems require you to hold the tie rod end in place while loosening the jam nut. Other systems may require you to hold one jam nut and loosen it while you hold in place another jam nut on the opposite end of the tie rod.
We're going to use the Calibro to do our initial adjustment. I'll do that, and then afterwards I'll show you how to use the tape measure to do so. Take your Calibro, and what you're going to do is put one end against the rim on one side and the other against the rim on the other side. So what this is doing is measuring the total distance between the rims on the front wheels. And you will then tighten it down. So distance between the two front wheels is as long as this. It doesn't necessarily have to be an exact measurement, because you're just going to be slipping this in and out to make sure that there's no space anyways. So we'll run it in the back here, put it against, and this is only slightly out of alignment. You can see the gap here. Now on this particular trike, it's got what is called a left-handed thread on one end of the tie rod ends. So you can move the tie rod and it'll change the total distance. You don't have to remove the tie rod end and twist it or anything like that. What I usually do is just twist the tie rod end until the rim has reached half the distance to the end of the Calibro. You do this because as you bring the back of the wheel in, the front of the wheel will go out. So half the distance should equal out to about the right alignment. Next, you'll take the Calibro back to the front of the wheel and remeasure now that you've changed it. Lock it in place, move it to the back again, and give it another check. Looks like we're a bit wide on the front now. So, give it a slight adjustment. Now what I'm gonna do here is just measure the back end. That way, you go ahead and measure the front right quick. Like we're still a touch wide there. It may take a couple measurements to get it just so. Now when you've got the alignment perfect, the Calibro will slip right in between the front of the two rims, and it'll also slip right in between the back of the front two rims. There should be no play or anything like that in it. Now, we're just gonna take it and, oh no! Put it out of adjustment again. Next, good old tape measure. So with the tape measure, what you're gonna wanna do is go to the front of the front rims, take it, and now this particular rim has a little ridge in the center of it. And I'm gonna use that point as my measuring point where I'm gonna take my measurement from. Now, if your rim doesn't have any sort of ridge or anything like that, you can measure off one of the spokes. And when you're measuring off a spoke, you want to make sure that on the front and the back of the rim, that you're measuring on both either inside or outside spokes, because they are positioned differently on the rim. Now, I'm going to measure from that ridge to the rim. So I got about 13 and a half. Measure the back. Weighs inside 13 and a half. I'm gonna go ahead and measure the other side before I make any changes. Now again, on this front side, it's got about 13 and a half. On the back, we're looking at about 13 and a half. So, although this side is more off than this side, still need to adjust the tie rod and even that up. I am just going to give it a couple twists. Measure it again. Looks like I got it right on. Probably not gonna be that lucky, so you may need to do a couple measurements and a couple adjustments. So once you're done with the alignment, you gotta go ahead and tighten up the tie rod ends again. When you're doing this, you wanna make sure that your tie rod ends are at the same position on both sides. So you can see I've got mine evened up so that when I tighten them, because they do change position when you move the handlebars, that they'll allow the most amount of travel. So I'm gonna go ahead and tighten this up. Use this wrench to hold it in place, and this wrench to tighten the jam nut against the tie rod end. And we've done the alignment on a direct steering type trike. So the direct steering means that the handlebar is linked directly to the headset and kingpin and spindle. It uses a single tie rod rather than two, which you would find on an indirect type steering system. This particular trike is the KMX Tornado. Once again, this is Matt with Utah Trikes. Technical tip, adjusting your alignment. Hi, I'm Matt from Utah Trikes, and today we're going to talk about...
Today we're going to talk about aligning your trike.
With Hans. My name is Hans. Once again, this is Matt with Utah Trikes. Technical tip, adjusting your...